Well, hello and welcome back to yet another one of my Outlander videos and my review of episode 11 of season 3. Now, with two episodes to go, it is the beginning of the end for the season. And once more, may I remind you, I'll be bringing you news and discussion videos over the course of the show's break, and that could pretty much extend from a year to a long year and a half, just like the case was between seasons 2 and 3. Let me remind you as well that you can suggest me reviewing any show of your liking here on What the Geek. So do feel free to drop any suggestions down below in the comments, and if I watch it, I'm gonna review it. But anyway, with being this close to the finale of the season as well, we're in for meeting a whole bunch of characters that we haven't seen in a while. I will try to discuss those characters at the very end of this video with a spoiler alert and all in order to avoid spoiling all of that over here. But speaking of episode 11, that was yet another good episode on the third season of Outlander. And I've got to admit that while a lot of people watch the series for the romantic aspect, I kind of sometimes prefer the separation of the two lovebirds, both on the series and in the novel. Surprisingly enough, it does actually kind of present us with a stronger display of their romance, with how hard they keep trying to get back together, or how hard they are working on saving one another from some danger or the other. It basically kind of adds to the adventurous entertainment the show has been presenting us with every once in a while over the course of three seasons so far. In other words, and in a way, it is actually when the romance seems to shine in a subtle yet amazing manner. But there is also this other thing that I find myself having not talked about for a few episodes now, since the reunion episode to be exact. And that would pretty much be the historical touch to all of it. I'm pretty sure if you're not finding me for the first time, you'd know this, but I'm just always fascinated with the portrayals of different time periods on various TV series, and this one does a good job with presenting us with such a touch, from the buildings to the carriages and the fashion sense. However though, and in order not to prolong my rant about how much I've enjoyed watching this episode, let's just jump into discussing our top moments for this episode and what I thought of each and every one of them. Number 1. Welcome to Hispaniola, where Claire has drifted after her jumping overboard the porpoise with the help of Annika Johansson on last week's episode. Annika is definitely one character that is gonna be missed. Now, I do think there was a lot of time wasted at the very start, even though it was entertaining watching Claire survive while trying her best to avoid dying of thirst. It did all feel to me a bit Tom Hanks or Castaway, except Claire didn't grow an insanely huge and uneven beard. That would have been weird if she did. However though, I don't really think she needed to explain the rule of threes to us or spend almost an entire minute trying to get a fire started. I mean, one or two of the many things we watched there could have implied the hell she had to go through and save more time for bigger arcs. Believe it or not, there was much on previous episodes and more on episodes to come that are a lot more worthy of this time being invested into them. But nonetheless, that doesn't make it all less entertaining. As a matter of fact, it was actually very entertaining. Those big ass ants, for example, were pretty scary. I hate those things when they come in groups of two or three, which makes them kind of painful in big numbers. Well, what was even scarier was that snake. I think I would have been scared shitless right there. I actually found it a bit out there that she could handle herself around a snake, but I'm guessing it's all because she has some military experience. Now, one thing I did like about this whole sequence is the change to her makeup throughout this journey throughout the jungle. I mean, it actually felt like this whole thing had her aging quicker than the usual. On another note though, I do love it when body language and facial expressions together do all the acting with limited to no verbal expressions. And that basically made her sort of Amy Brenneman on the first season of The Leftovers, and Tom Hanks on Castaway, two of my favorite non-speaking roles ever. Number 2 though. Now, almost 16 minutes into the events of the episode, Claire has made it to a place where people actually exist, meeting up with Mamacita first and foremost. And Mamacita there is definitely as aggressive and seemingly as cruel as she is in the novel. But she's doing it all from a place of conflicted emotion and a place of good. But once again, the zipper was a source of amazement for yet another character, just like it was for Jamie on A Malcolm. That just felt like some kind of callback to that. These little details are really worthy of admiration here. Now, one other thing I did love about this whole sequence was how the show kind of changed course, moving away from the incredible Claire trope and working with a different kind of arc. This time around, she's basically the helpless one being taken care of by others, and in the medical sense as well. And speaking of others, number 3. The disgraced priest from Voyager, Father Fogden, makes his debut as well. He's kind of a very nice man, very likable, and right away you kind of feel familiar with him. But with the kindness comes a little bit of crazy as well, that you kind of find pretty funny. Like I stated last week, it is all kind of part of the show trying to put this one touch of comedy on every single episode of the season. And this week, the comic relief was Father Fogden. So yes, that was a pretty good portrayal there. I did love how Claire seemed worried and kind of a bit scared there when he started talking to that coconut, even though he seemed pretty harmless. I mean, he's no Jack Randall. I found it funny as well that he did not ask her for a name and instead referred to her as Madam Physician in his conversation with Mamacita. And given the variation in size between her and Mamacita, I did find it funny as well how Mamacita referred to Claire as a cow. That actress, though, does know how to put on a serious, frowning poker face right there. I think I actually started laughing almost every time she said a word or even showed up on this episode. I mean, seriously, that dinner scene, why would you look at someone you just served food with that much hatred and aggression, like you slipped poison into his or her dish? And the answer simply is number 4. Mamacita is mother to none other than the priest's now dead wife, who was the source of the disgrace that I mentioned earlier. So it is kind of understandable why she was so upset with Claire, given Fogden was very keen on caring for her and her needs, even offering to travel with her to the nearest village, not wanting to allow her to leave on her own. And he did as well seem to be getting a little bit obsessive over keeping her around. And Mamacita, she just erroneously thought that someone was about to replace her daughter in Fogden's life. Now, I don't think something is wrong with Claire, but I don't think as well every other woman should be threatened by her presence, like she's the most beautiful woman in the whole wide world. But anyway, once again Claire is being referred to as a whore, this time though by Mamacita, echoing her very same description of Claire's from the Voyager novel. Number 5 though. This episode apparently did away with Lawrence Stern. Now Lawrence in the novel was actually the one who brought Claire to Hacienda de la Fuente, and he was actually a source of additional anger to Mamacita. Can you imagine her being more angry? Number 6 though. The Sacred Cave of Abandaway. Now this is the very same cave that was mentioned by Margaret Campbell a few episodes ago. Abandaway will devour you. The thing about this cave was that the search for young Ian is gonna be taking Jamie and Claire right there. The other thing about this cave though is that Team Claire is gonna be meeting up with an old acquaintance, one I expect will be making their first appearance on next week's episode. I'm also expecting said acquaintance is gonna be sticking around for the finale as well. But that very acquaintance is the same white female with the 200 years old bones from earlier this season, the ones that Joe Abernathy shared with Claire. And yes, this is one part I'm extremely excited about. Number 7 though. Luckily for Jamie, he didn't make it to Jamaica and didn't get arrested. The Artemis has had an incident leading everyone right to where Claire and Jamie would reunite, Hispaniola. And while they try to fix the masts of the ship in the hopes of sailing as quickly as possible to Jamaica and Jamie reuniting with Claire, Claire is on her way to reunite with Jamie, Fergus, and Marsali. The music though for the reunion scene did sound a little bit like some of the Tudor's music from its early seasons. But moving on to number 8. It is really entertaining how Tincho or Mr. Willoughby has so little scenes, yet he's the kind of character we enjoy watching in action, even for those little moments he's party to. I mean, since his speech 2 episodes ago, saving the day and stopping everyone from going nuts and turning against one another on board of the Artemis, I'm sure a lot of fans are in love with him. Number 9 though. Jamie keeps his promise. He's given Fergus and Marsali his blessing, and he intends to keep his promise in giving them a wedding. So we actually got to see the interesting character that Father Fogden is for a few more moments there, as he marries away both Fergus and Marsali. But before we actually get to the wedding, there was the birth control talk between Marsali and Claire. And it was quite entertaining watching Claire being a mother to her sort of future daughter-in-law and the daughter of her arch-nemesis. Marsali as well got a lot of character development with that scene. I mean, the girl is quite perceptive. She might actually sound like a pain when it comes to Claire, but she does realize Claire is a wiser woman than her mother and the one capable of making Jamie happy. So she does open up in telling her how she noticed it was different between her and Jamie than it was between Leary and Jamie. A very fun conversation with very strong character development for Marsali, if you ask me. Also, I kind of hate to say I told you so, but I did tell you so. Marsali is a very Claire-like personality. She does sound like a pain at times, but she's just as stubborn as Claire and has her softer, kinder, and more fun moments. But that also brings us to number 10. The entire wedding sequence was kind of funny, from the conversation about the missing hand to the part about Fergus missing other stuff, to Marsali speaking her mind and all the jokes that came with it. But then there was the Fergus-Fraser moment. It was very touching actually, how Jamie gives him his name after all these years, allowing Father Fogden to marry him and Marsali. But finally though, number 11. The hilarious moments on this episode did not just stop with Father Fogden. The entire scene with the penicillin and Jamie trying to inject Claire with it was quite the hilarious moment as well, even though he totally failed at getting together his courage to do so. The entire sequence as well was quite the funny and entertaining highlight to end the episode on, especially that we're in for some serious stuff going forward. But all in all, it was a great episode, so much fun there, very entertaining. I actually think it is one of my favorites this season, and one of the lighter ones as well, even though it is supposed to reflect a certain level of pain and agony on the couple's end. Now, should I discuss that character with the bones and all these characters we should be reuniting with pretty soon, I think I'm not going to spoil that on this video. It is only a matter of days before you come to find out all about it for yourself. So instead, let me know in the comments what you thought of this episode. Let me know as well if you're excited for all that is to come over the remaining episodes of the season. And remember to slap this video a much appreciated like if you did like its content, and while you're at it, you can always subscribe and enable notifications as well. But until I see you next time, thank you all for tuning in and have a good one.